Welcome. See these sums. I will show one by one. Since I have done this one, I will start with this one. The value of lambda for which the equation this one represents two straight lines. We have to find the value of lambda such that this one represents a pair of straight lines. We are knowing that if the equation ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equals to 0, if it represents a pair of straight lines, then this one will be 0, this determinant value will be 0. Or if you like, you can write this one. This is the same thing as this determinant, abc plus 2fgh minus af square minus bg square minus ch square equals to 0, then only this will represent a pair of straight lines. Now our given equation is this one. Comparing with this equation, we have to say a equals to 6, 2h equals to minus 42, so h equals to minus 21. B equals to 60, 2g equals to minus 11, that is g equals to minus 11 by 2, 2f equals to 37, so f equals to 37 by 2, and c equals to minus 5 lambda. Using these values either in this determinant or in this equation, we have to find the value of lambda. So I am putting in this equation, we are putting all these values, 6 into b into c plus 2fgh minus a into f square minus b into g square minus c into h square, this one equals to 0. If we are solving this equation, then we will get lambda equals to minus 1, and this will be our answer. Here remember, these values may not be very simple, but we have to do these calculations. Either you can use this equation directly or you can use the determinant. By using any of the two, you have to find this value. Now proceed to the next sum. Let us proceed from here. If a line y equals to 2x cuts the curve this one at the points A and B, then the equation of a circle with AB as diameter is. So y equals to 2x, if we are putting here, that means x square plus, instead of y we are putting 2x, so y square will be 4x square minus 10x equals to 0. That is 5x square minus 10x. So if we are taking 5x common, that is x minus 2 will be 0. So we are getting two values of x. X equals to, from here we are getting x equals to 0. From here we are getting x equals to 2. By using these two values, we are getting corresponding values of y. Y equals to 2x. So y we are getting 0, 4. So the points are 0, 0 and 2, 4. These are the two points A and B. So this is the diameter. Then its midpoint will be the center, midpoint will be 0 plus 2 by 2, that is 1, and 0 plus 4 by 2, that will be 2. So this will be the center. Your next midpoint of the diameter is the center, and from center to any end we can find radius. So radius equals to root of 1 minus 0 is 1 square, plus 2 minus 0 is also 2 square, so equals to root 5. So the equation of the circle will be x minus 1 whole square plus y minus 2 whole square equals to root 5 whole square, that is 5, or x square minus 2x plus 1 plus y square minus 4x plus 4 equals to 5. So this 1, 4, 5 will cut. So what we can say, x square plus y square minus 2x minus, this is supposed to be 4y, minus 2x minus 4y equals to 0. This is our the equation of the circle which we are required to find. Now we will proceed to the next circle. Now let us see this one. A variable line passes through the intersection of the curves x plus 2y equals to 4 and 2x plus y equals to 4 and cuts the x and y axis at A and B respectively, the locus of the midpoint of AB. So first of all, since it passes through the intersection, we will solve these two lines. 2x plus y equals to 4, multiplying this one by 2, 2x plus 4y equals to 8. By subtraction, what we are getting, minus 3y equals to minus 4. So y equals to 4 by 3. Now by putting y, so what we are getting, x plus 2 into 4 by 3 equals to 4, or x equals to 4 minus 8 by 3. That is 12 minus 8, 4. So x equals to 4 by 3. So we are getting the point is 4 by 3 comma 4 by 3. This is the point of intersection. Now the line, suppose this is the line. So this is the point A, this is the point B. If we are assuming the equation of the line B, x by A plus y by B equals to 1, then this point is A comma 0, this point will be 0 B. Hence the midpoint will be A plus 0 by 2, that is A by 2, and B plus 0 by 2, B by 2. We have to find the locus of this midpoint. So we can say x equals to A by 2, y equals to B by 2. Or we can say A equals to 2x, B equals to 2y. Now we are knowing that this line is passing through the point 4 by 3, 4 by 3. So you can say 4 by 3 by A plus 4 by 3 by B equals to 1, or 4 by 3 into 1 by A plus 1 by B equals to 1, or we can say 1 by A plus 1 by B equals to 3 by 4. But instead of A, if we are putting 2x, so 1 by 2x plus 1 by B, we are putting 2y equals to 3 by 4. That we are getting, multiplying by 2, 1 by x plus 1 by y equals to 3 by 4 into 2 will be 3 by 2. So this will be our the locus of this midpoint. Now we can proceed to the next sum. See this one, the distance of the point 2, 3 from the line this one measured parallel to the line this one. When measured parallel to the line this one, first of all we have to find a line parallel to this one passing through 2, 3. Any line parallel to x minus y equals to 0 is x minus y equals to k. Since it is passing through 2, 3, we can say 2 minus 3 equals to k, that is k equals to minus 1. Hence the line will be x minus y equals to minus 1. This is the line which is passing through 2, 3 and parallel to this one. Now we find the point of intersection of this line and this line. So we can write 2x minus 3y equals to minus 9. Now multiplying this one by 2, we can write 2x minus 2y equals to minus 2. By subtraction, what we are getting? Minus y equals to minus 7. That is y equals to 7. By putting this value of y, we are getting x equals to y is 7, so x equals to minus 1 plus 7, that is equals to 6. So the point is becoming 6, 7. Now 6, 7 is the point which is passing through 2, 3 and parallel to this line and intersecting this line. So we have to find the distance between 6, 7 and 2, 3. So the distance will be root of 6 minus 2 whole square plus 7 minus 3 whole square. 6 minus 2 is 4, 4 square is 16, plus 7 minus 3 is also 4, it's 16, that is root 32, so 4 root 2. Hence, this will be our answer. See the method how we have done. First, we are finding a line parallel to this one and passing through this one. Then, find the point of intersection of that line and this line. Then, finding the distance between this point and that point. In this way, we can do these sums.